Modular synthesizers are hot these days. Reason for us to check out the free Modulaire synthesizer made by Full Bucket. With over 50 different modules, it's really most impressive. So stay tuned. First, let me ask you to subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you subscribe, we will keep you updated on all the great free software and tools we review. Full Bucket is known for its fantastic free synthesizer plugins, and we already reviewed several of them on our channel. The Modulaire we review in this video shows us a new way of looking at modular synthesizers, and it has so many great features. First, check out how we can download and install it, and then take a look on how it works. The download comes as a zip file for Windows and a PKG file for Mac. We downloaded the zip for Windows and found several files in the folder. There's a 34-page manual for the plugin, which can help you a lot. But the important file is the DLL file that you have to copy to the folder on your computer where you have stored all the plugins so your DAW can read them. So if you have a 64-bit computer, you copy the modular64.dll to your plugin folder, and for a 32-bit computer there's the modular.dll. The other two DLL files with the letters FX in it are for VST hosts that sometimes can't use the modular in the effect zone. This is explained at page 5 in the manual. After copying the DLL to the right folder, you can start your DAW. The Modulaire is a modular synthesizer that can hold 18 different modules per patch, and you can choose out of 51 modules, but there could be more modules in future. This is version 1.1.0 we review at the moment. As you see, there are 18 spaces, and if you click on the top of the space, you can choose one of the many modules. They are neatly organized in groups like oscillators, filters, amps, processors, modulators, sequences, effects and tools. Now, before we dive into this modular synthesizer, let's check out what the Wikipedia says about modular synthesizers. These are synthesizers composed of separate modules of different functions. The modules can be connected together with patch cords, a matrix patching system, or switches by the user to create a patch. Every module does something to the audio signal, and you can decide in which order the signal will flow. Or you can decide that the signal should be affected or modulated by several modules at the same time. And in this plugin, you can do that by patching or switching the modules. To find out how, let's check out the first program or patch that's in this Modulaire and see how it's built up. At the left you see the common section, which always is there. Here you can select and rename the programs, apply MIDI learn, set the amount of voices, control the master volume, set the pitch bend and copy and save and load programs or patches. So when we load program number 0, we see that it loads 8 modules. At the left we see two blocks named dual oscillators 1 and 2. So this patch uses 4 oscillators. Next we see two blocks with filters. One amplifier, one LFO, and the last one is a voltage processor. In this patch, the 4 oscillators are all connected to the 4 filters input. You can see that because under the input A and B knobs at the filters, you see a blue field that tells us that the oscillator 1A is connected to input A of the first filter. A nice feature is that if you hover over the blue field, you will see that the part that it's connected to is highlighted. In this case, the first waveform of oscillator 1. So if you hover over the other inputs of the filters, you see the other oscillators lighting up. The same goes for the amplifier. Input A and B are connected to filter 1 and 2. If you click on the blue field, you can select another source for your input. At the bottom of some of the modules, you see the modulation area. And there you see a yellow field which tells you which module is modulating this section. So all 4 oscillators are modulated by LFO1, the filter by a part of the voltage processor. But some of the yellow fields do not highlight any connection to another module. Like the second modulation knob of the filter is set to note, so it changes by playing different notes on your keyboard. As you can see, you can click on the yellow field and choose from a list. So you can change the filter using the pitch bend or modulation wheel, or an after touch by note or by velocity. On the amplifier you see that it's modulated by the velocity in this patch. Now about the modules. There are some very interesting modules in this modulaire, which you would not expect in a free instrument. Besides the standard oscillators, there's also an FM oscillator, a formant and even a wavetable oscillator. If you listen to program number 17, you can hear that it plays a wavetable that says wavetable synthesis.
Wavetable synthesis.
Wavetable synthesis. Wavetable synthesis.
Wavetable synthesis.
Many different types of filters and also the processors have modules like a ring modulator or a Hilbert processor. The sequences also are diverse. Let's check out program number 6. Here you see the sequencer at the lower row. And this single sequencer can play 8 notes. But if you use multiple sequences, you can link them so the first sequencer will play its notes first and then step over to the second sequencer and then to the third one. Note that the sequencer only will run when you start your DAW, because it is connected to it, so it will play at the same tempo. In program 12 you see the sequence switch in action, where it will trigger the notes in a rhythm. In program 14, you see another type of sequencer, the beat sequencer. It can trigger like in a drum machine. Just listen and see what it does. And there are even effects in it, like delay, which you can listen to in program 39. And reverb in program 40. The tools also have an oscilloscope that you can use to show the waveform, like in program number 50. Most of the patches are examples on how to use a certain oscillator or a filter, but some of the patches are already great sounds. I can imagine that you want to dive into this great modular synth. Every module is explained in the PDF manual, so you will have lots of fun exploring this fantastic free beast. You might want to save the bank of this synthesizer so you can get back to the presets whenever you make a mistake. When you change the sound, it will automatically be saved in the memory, so the previous sound is gone. The last 9 programs are still empty, so you can copy a program to start working on it and paste it on one of the init programs at the end. So now let me play some of the programs so you can hear how fantastic this machine is. More information and the download link can be found on our website. The link is below this video. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep you updated on all the great and free software we review.
Thank you. I'm